After it's released, I've decided to buy Canon's EOS R. I know, there are literally hundreds of videos out there telling you why you should buy EOS R and why you should not buy EOS R. That's not what I'm doing here. So why should you watch this video? You don't have to. But see, here's the thing. I'm not telling you anything technical about EOS R. I'm telling you why, as a hobby photographer, I bought an EOS R. Of course, the technical aspects are there, which led to its purchase, but that's not gonna be the main focus of this video. The main focus is the non-technical reasons why I bought this camera. To be precise, there are exactly three reasons, and I'm about to share with you those three reasons. How will it benefit you? Well, it may or may not. But it's possible that you can relate to the same reasons as I have, and that can help you in deciding whether you want to buy this camera, use it, or try it, or rain. Well, since I live in Austria, so my reasons are more true to the region of Europe, Central Europe, basically Austria, Germany. But that's not to say that you can't relate to it. Maybe in your part of the world, you can also have the same situation or the same reasons. If you are watching this video, I guess you are interested in this camera, or at least you are interested in photography. I've been using a Canon's crop sensor camera 600D for last 7 years. And over the years, I have accumulated a lot of Canon accessories. Although I don't have a full frame camera, but the lenses I have, they can be used with a full frame. So there it is. I'm a Canon user and I wanted to upgrade to full frame. So being a Canon user, it's a no-brainer that I wanted to upgrade to another Canon. That would be my first reason, Canon to Canon. Let's jump over to the second reason, which is probably the most important of the three reasons, because when I was looking into buying full frame camera, then I decided to ask around if anyone had a secondhand camera, which I could probably buy. I went to ask one of the local photographers and I saw he was shooting with Canon EOS R. Canon EOS R was pretty new at that time and RP had not even came out. So I asked him if he had a secondhand camera to sell. Unfortunately, he has sold everything, whatever he had before, except for his lenses, because he could use the lens again on EOS R. He didn't have a camera to sell at that time. So I was like, okay, what do you have now? And he said, I'm shooting with EOS R. I was like, okay, well, I've heard so much negative things about it on YouTube and everywhere else. Well, he said he had no complaints with it. He was shooting with it. Since I am familiar with his work, I have seen his photographs which he has taken with the Canon EOS R. I couldn't find any problem with it. And during the conversation, he told me something that almost 99.9% made it sure for me that if I buy a new camera, I'm going to buy a Canon EOS R. And that point was that mirrorless is the future. A lot of photographers are still going to argue about it, but that rings true to everywhere in this world. Mirrorless is going to be the future. So this was the second and the most important point, that mirrorless is the future. I wanted to buy a full frame camera, but all the full frame cameras out there were extremely, excruciatingly, painfully expensive for a hobbyist. Although EOS R is not as expensive as many other models from Canon, which are full frame and professional, but still it's pretty expensive. Especially if you're not a professional, you're not earning any money from it. I'm not earning, certainly. So the third and the last problem was, should I buy it or should I still wait for it? And I waited. So it happens that one day I was in MediaMarkt. MediaMarkt is a electronics handler. They sell everything electronic. So I was in the shop and I saw a board, it said 0% finance. What should I do? Should I go for it or shouldn't I? I decided I go for 0% finance, and that's it. I got EOS R for 0% finance. This scheme is available in Austria, but it's possible that wherever you live, there are other schemes available, similar maybe. My decision to buy this camera was a combination of these three. Me being a Canon user, mirrorless is the future, and ease of buying it on installments without paying any extra interest. That means I still pay the same amount of money over a longer span of time. Made sense to me, so I went for it. Those were the three reasons. Well, being a bit cheeky here, another one of the most important reasons was the autofocus on the eyes. That is a must. In this camera where I'm shooting right now, this is the 600D. If I go a bit closer, I'm going to go out of focus. If I go a bit too much back, I'm out of focus, which is not going to be a problem in EOS R. So that's it. That's all I wanted to share with you. And I hope you like it. I'm going to show you this camera now. Well, not really. You've seen it. You know how it looks. If you're watching this video, I'm sure you've watched a lot of other videos. You know how it looks. I'll see you in the next video. My name is Avi, and you are watching Colors of Light.